a life that is worthy of a ministry. Live a life that can attract somebody.
Do you desire to be fruitful? The qualification for fruitfulness is that you must
abide in him.
It's here. Settle. Settle.
When men shall say, there's a casting down, you will announce that there is a lifting up.
One of our pastors here asked me a question while I was going on Thursday, yes. He stopped me and he asked me a question. He said, a man of God preached a message, and that the man of God said, I'm quoting him now, that while I traveled, I invited one of my friends from Lagos, and he came here and preached a message, and the message he preached was not out of place. He preached a message and said that Cain was cursed, but that he built a city. And that he built a city. So he was asking me, my son was asking me, Daddy, how do you reconcile this? And I said to him, okay, I will answer you. And I know that in the heart of many of you who were here when he preached that message, the question might be in your heart as well. And I will answer you. And now listen to me. I am a tutor and grounded theologian, and you don't have a problem when it comes to doctrinal and dogmatic issues that is relating to the Bible. Now listen to me. I want to make it clear to you that there is a difference between the time a man commits sin and the time that curse come upon the man. I will explain what I mean. Every sin is not tantamount to curse. That was why I told you that day that curses are placed. I give you instance. From the time that Noah was drunk and his last son saw his nakedness, that was not the time the boy was cursed. After seeing the father's nakedness, he walked out of that place laughing. He walked out of that place still normal. There was no curse on him, though he has committed the sin. But the curse came on him. When what happened? The curse came on him when the father woke up from his drunkenness and discovered what the son has done. Now, when the father woke up and discovered what the son had done, the father did not even cause him harm. Rather, the father now caused his last son, Canaan, and said, Canaan, servant of servants shall you be to your brothers. Come on now. But the curse did not come at that time when he committed the sin. Again, when Cain killed Abel, curse did not come to him at that time. When he killed Abel, he was not cursed. He finished killing Abel, walked out from there, started living his life, was doing his thing, was on his own, was doing well. After he had killed Abel, that was why in Genesis chapter 4, when God wanted to curse Cain, God said, now art thou cursed. That means before now, you were not cursed. He said, now art thou cursed. From this time that I place curse on you, henceforth it will start happening to you. That means before the curse came, after killing the brother, he was still normal. And that was why, as at the point when God was releasing the curse, he had opportunity to dialogue with God. And he said to God, this thing you are cursing me now is more than I can bear. The curse was just coming. The curse was not there before. So after killing his brother Abel, he was not cursed. That is the reason the Bible said, now art thou cursed. cost. It is now that the cost is coming on you. It is now that the evil is coming on you. I give you another one. When Reuben slept with the father's concubine, after Reuben slept with the father's concubine, cause did not come on Reuben until Genesis 39, when the father was getting ready to die. He said, come together, all you sons of Jacob, that I may tell you what will become of you. And now they now came together. But all this while, they've been going free. Everybody have been on their own. They've been enjoying life. But when he gathered them together, he now said, now the cause will come. Does that explain it to you? So it is from the point when the curse came. Ladies and gentlemen, every father is a gift. Every father is a gift. Whether your father is alive or dead, your father is a gift. Every father is a gift. Father's Day celebration is a celebration for every man. Without a father, none of us will be here. You can call anybody anything. You can say you are a bastard. You can say anything. But the truth of the matter is that you have a father, but you don't know who your father is. But somebody is your father. That you don't know him does not mean he does not exist. Am I talking to somebody right now? And every father is a gift. Without a father, no man will be in this room. Without a father, no man will be on earth. What the woman has is a womb that incubates a child, but it is the man that carries the semen that produces the child. Without the man, there cannot be any human. Men, your role in life is vital. No matter how rich a woman is, there is something missing in her life if there is no man by her side. True or false? Eh? The truth of the matter is that no matter how educated a woman is, if there is no man by her side, she is incomplete. Am I saying the truth? No matter how religious a woman is, no matter how anointed you are, without a father, there is an issue. Without a man around, there is an issue. How many of you agree with me? Eh? How many of you here know that no matter how powerful a man you are, you need another man? Eh? It gives you joy to know you have a father somewhere. Every one of you who truly belong to this commission, when you wake up from your sleep in the morning and you remember that I'm still alive, there's a kind of strength that comes on the inside of you. That's what a father does. That's what a father does. What makes you a father is not how many biological children that you have. Eh? It's not how many biological children that you have. It is how many people you've been able to influence. How many of you know that your father influences you? There are children you give birth to that you are not even fathering. I'm sorry, if I have time, I will teach you. You give birth to them. You are their father biologically, but you are not their father in real sense. Because what is about a father? Discover this. When you have a father, you are influenced by your father. Eh? Come on now. How many of you know you follow a man until such a time you begin to walk the way he walk? You talk like he talk. You behave like he does. That is a father. He's influencing you. He's impacting into you. You are becoming like him. That's a father. A father is influential. It doesn't take money to be influential. It doesn't take anything to be influential. It takes you to be influential. It takes you. Just be who you are. And you know how many people you'll be able to influence. Ladies and gentlemen, in my life, I've been encouraged more by my sons in the Lord than every other person I see on the face of the earth. In the face of stumbling blocks, they will just show up and they will do something. They will do something that will want to keep you moving. If you're a father in this place, stand up and say, I'm a father. You're not talking like you are sure. Say it one more time. Say, I'm a father. God bless you. Sit down, but don't go down. I am not going to patronize the men, But I'm going to continue on the series. I want to talk about the Father's course. Because today is the Father's Day. Let me talk on the Father's course. Somebody very quickly, turn to Matthew chapter 15. Matthew chapter 15. I want to talk about the Father's course. Matthew chapter 15. Another person, turn to the book of Proverbs chapter 20 and verse 20. Matthew 15 and verse 4. Exodus 21 and verse 17. Leviticus 20 and verse 9. Anybody there, anyone you get first, be ready to read for me. Matthew chapter 15 and verse number 4. Now listen to me. Listen to me. Matthew chapter 15 and verse number 4. Listen very carefully.
For God commanded.
For God, not man. For God commanded. Listen, not God command. God commanded. He has done it before we got here. There is a commandment from God. It is not a suggestion, it's a commandment. It is not an appeal, it's a commandment. For God commanded. God commanded. The action word there is the command. The ED is only telling us the timing. Action word is the command. The ED is not part of the statemental statement. Neither is it part of the phrase or the clause if you want. But the ED there is only pointing out the timing. For God commanded. Before you got here, there was a commandment that is in existence. He didn't see you before he brought the commandment. He did not see me before he brought the commandment. The commandment came before our fathers got here. For his words are settled in heaven before the foundation of the earth. For God commanded, saying,
honor your father and your mother.
Honor your father and your mother.
And he who calls father or mother, let him be put to death.
Are we reading the New Testament? Is this the New Testament?
Yes, sir.
He who curses father or mother, let him be put to death. There is a death sentence on every child that curses the father or the mother. I will teach you Bible. The word curses in this context, when the Bible says who curses the father and the mother, the word cursing here simply means to take for granted, to belittle. Anybody who belittle the father, anybody who belittle the father should be put to death. It's a commandment. And who passed that commandment? Somebody say God. Can I tell you what it means? Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible said anybody who cursed the father or the mother should be put to death. If I didn't know my Bible, I would be afraid. What does that mean? Then who will put the person to death? How is it going to happen? But because I have read my Bible, I saw my Bible when God declared before now to Adam and Eve. God said to Adam, the day you shall eat of this forbidden fruit, you shall die. The devil came to him and said, it is a lie. You shall not die. Your eyes will open. But the death God was talking about is the death that is worse than ordinary death. The devil was referring to natural death, death of the human flesh. But God was talking about spiritual death. And the Bible said, any man that curseth the father
father shall die. There are many listening to me right now. Without apology, we are going to ask God to redeem you, and you will come back to life, because many of us are dead. We are moving, we are breathing, we are walking, but we are dead. We are dead because we have cursed our father. We are dead because we have said things we shouldn't say. So we are dead. Your struggle cannot change it. I believe it, I don't believe it, cannot change it. I am born again 70 times, cannot change it. I am filled with this, I'm filled with that, cannot change it. For my Bible says God is merciful. My Bible says God is long suffering. My God is said he forgiveth sins, but that does not clear the guilty. It does not clear the guilty. When he told Adam at the Garden of Eden, the day you eat of the forbidden fruit, you shall die. Adam ate of the forbidden fruit. My heart broke when Adam heard the steps of God in the garden. The same Adam that used to meet with God every evening ran away and hid himself. And God said, Adam, where are you? He said, I heard your voice in the garden. I am no more qualified to appear before you. I ran away and I hid myself. God said, only one thing will make you hide. Anytime you see God and hide, there is a curse on you. There is death on you. And God said, only one thing will make you run. You have eaten the forbidden fruit. You have done what I ask you not to do. Anytime you curse your father, you separate yourself from God. And he said, I am the vine and you are the branch. Cut off from me, you can do nothing. When you curse your father, your labor amounts to nothing. You will work and get nothing. You will labor and get nothing, because you are dead to God. Said, any man that curses his father should die. Let him be put to death. There are many of us in this meeting today that are guilty. Many of us who are not guilty, we are guilty because our fathers are guilty. Whichever way you look at it, any guilty man here that is dead to God because of cursing the father, today I pray for you. The mercies of God will set you free. Proverbs 20:20, anybody there? Whoso curseth his father
or his mother, his lamp shall be put out.
God bless you. Come. Whoso curseth his father or his mother, his lamp shall be put out. And now listen, when he says his lamp shall be put out, you know what the Bible said? In obscure darkness. Whoso curses his father or his mother, that person's lamp shall be put out. Your light will not be put out in brightness. God will wait for you when you are where you need the light most. In obscure darkness, where you needed the light the most. The Bible said, in obscure darkness. That means you already in the midst of that darkness, your light will be put out. There are many listening to the sound of my voice. You will find yourself in a dark place, but you can't find light. Over the years, you've been looking for light, you cannot find light. Turn around, something is wrong somewhere. You have broken an edge and the serpent is biting. I came as a messenger of God in this end time. I came sent by God. After today, what But your lamp shall bring back your lamp. In obscure darkness, I don't know who is listening to me, and the word of God is hitting you right now, and the word of God is coming to you with power and efficacy, and you are saying, man of God, this one is not story. I see myself in the Bible. I'm in the dark place and I can't find light. I'm in the dark place and I can't find light. Oh, my lamp is put out. I cannot find brightness anymore. I cannot find solution anymore. Oh, man of God, something is wrong. I have offended my father. I have offended my mother. My light has been taken out. Oh, help me, Lord. I don't know who you are, but as I speak on curses today, however your light was taken out in obscure darkness, I pray for you today the Lord shall set you free. I pray for you today the Lord shall deliver you. I pray for you today the Lord shall deliver you. Oh, somebody raise your voice and deliver me, Lord. Somebody raise your voice and deliver me, Lord. Somebody raise your voice and deliver me, Lord. Hey!
However your light was put off, however your lamp was put off in obscure darkness, today I speak in the name of Jesus Christ. May your lamp be restored. May your light 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 be restored. I say, may your light be restored. He will restore your lamp. He will restore your lamp. In the name of Jesus. He will restore your lamp. 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 I say, he will restore your lamp. I said, he will restore your lamp. I said, he will restore your lamp. In the name of Jesus Christ. I don't know how he came on you, but he will restore you. I don't know how it took place in your life, but he will restore you. I don't know how he came on you, but he will restore you. Somebody shall restore me, Lord. Somebody shall restore me, Lord. He says his lamp shall be put out. He didn't say his light shall be put out. He didn't say his light shall be quenched. Now, when your light quench, you can still have your lamp. When your light is off, you can still have the lamp. So another time, in the course of the journey of your life, you may on it again. But when your lamp is taken out, there is no hope of light. Oh, come on now. Oh, come on now. Am I telling you, Bible? The Bible did not say his light shall be put out. It said his lamp shall be put out. That is to say, his lamp shall be taken away from him. There is no hope of light. There are people listening to me now. You are in situations and conditions where you can't see light coming. There is no hope for light because the lamp is not there. I came today as a messenger of God. As I speak in this series of breaking curses, the Lord shall restore your lamp. The Lord shall restore your lamp. The Lord shall restore your lamp. If you stand up and shout the loudest amen, he will do it now. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Somebody say, restore my lamp, oh God. Your lamp shall be restored. If you shout a better amen, something will happen in the realm of the spirit. I am empowered by God to break it. Something will happen in the realm of the spirit.
Something will happen in the realm of the spirit. Lamp of your husband has been quenched.
Odigi he digi tinyere aka na aga aga.
Your husband is a graduate but cannot keep a job for 1 month.
Yes, sir, you are correct.
If he gets a job, he must lose it.
Yes.
If he gets a job, he must lose it.
Yes.
He has written many applications, countless applications. But he can't keep anyone.
Yes.
The last job he did was to become a PA to House of Assembly member who is his friend.
You are right, Daddy. You are right.
His own friend. They both went to school together. They went to secondary school here in Aba. The other one contested before and didn't win. Contested again, didn't win. Contested and he won this time. Your husband, he picked your husband to be his PA. For both of them to work together, the work lasted for 1 week.
Yes.
After 1 week, the husband was asked to go without no reason. Is there anybody listening to me here whose lamp has been put out? When the lamp of a man is put out, no matter how you struggle, nothing happens. No matter how you labor, nothing happens. No matter how you struggle, nothing happens. Because the lamp has been put out. Your husband is so ashamed of himself now. As I see your tears, woman, I feel for you. And I feel for him. Because as you're crying, that's how he cries. He doesn't go out anymore. He stays at home because of shame. He can't face his friends. Bright young man. But the light is put out. There's a man in this meeting. You were sleeping. Not long ago. Tying a wrapper on your waist. At the middle of the night, you didn't know a strange hand that came to remove the wrapper. Folded the wrapper very well. And dropped it by your side. The manipulation is coming from Obo, but it's happening here in Aba. Are you the man? The wrapper was folded like this.
Yes, sir. Exactly.
Like this.
Exactly.
Kept beside you. But this is something you tied on your waist
before
you slept.
Yes.
Only for you to wake up and discover that you are completely naked.
I am naked.
Who removed the wrapper? You didn't know. Not that it was folded anyhow. It was folded very well. Folded very well. And God said, that is how they folded you in Achara Obo. But I will get there now. By the word of prophecy, I don't know where they tied you. I don't know where they put out your lamp. I don't know how they put out your lamp. In this meeting today, the God that I serve, he will restore your lamp. 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 Somebody raise your voice and shout. Sir, I don't have all the time. I will give you assignment.
Yes, sir.
Go to your house right now.
Yes, sir.
Bring me that wrapper.
Yes, sir. I'm here with it, sir.
Bring it. Jesus. Sir. Right now, I will show you that the Tokunadu where you worship is not an ordinary place.
Thank God.
You are such a wise man. Come, look at the wrapper somebody tied to sleep. And do you know the funny part?
God told me that nobody was there with you.
And nobody. I'm with you alone in that room.
Inside the room all alone, tying this wrapper. Only for him to wake up at the middle of the night. Can this thing be folded by mistake?
No.
Can somebody roll and fold something like this? Only for him to wake up at the middle of the night and discover that he was naked.
Yes.
Checked himself and started looking around. Discovered that this thing was folded like this and kept beside him.
Yes. Exactly.
Because this is how he has been folded. Atachara Obowo over the years. That is why you cannot amount to anything. Everything you put your hand must scatter. You are getting old with nothing. The little thing you are supposed to get from your village, they are also collecting it. You are dying of hunger. Mburo sisi jiri wentu kwasi obi na village ono ha ebuole ya. There is nothing you put your hand that works. It is a curse. I don't know who you are here. Any curse upon your head. Any curse from your root. Any curse from your background. I speak by the authority of heaven. That curse shall be broken right now. The curse upon your husband is from all being. I step into that three-way junction.
Yes.
Where sacrifice was offered when he was in his second year in the University of Calabar. They made sacrifice there. The sacrifice was made by his stepmother who died 2 years ago. But your husband has been a graduate for 7 years now. But yet every door closed. But before he graduated, he was in school for 13 years. 13 years. Because there's a curse he was struggling with. He struggled with the curse for 11 years. The curse came when he was in his second year. The second year in the university. Then he spent another 11 years struggling with it. Managed to graduate 7 years ago. After service up until now. A bright, intelligent young man. His mate started working before he graduated. But he is out of school. But yet the destiny is hanging. I feel a push in my spirit right now. Every man, every woman in this hall, if your own has been dragging, if your own has been hanging, if your own has been dragging, I come in the name of the Lord. I come in the volume of the book that is written of me. I come with fire and thunder in my mouth. I release you today. That curse is hereby broken. 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 Brother, the curse is broken. Sister, the curse is broken. Brother, the curse is broken. Sister, the curse is broken. I break the curse from the root. I release you, God. Next week, Tuesday. Talking of next tomorrow, by 10:30 in the morning, ask your husband to go back to that honorable's office. Let him go back there. That will be the beginning of his miracle.
Amen.
Tell him that Tokunadu said that the curse has been broken.
Amen.
I am looking forward to seeing his testimony.
Amen.
Settle. 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 Help me tell your neighbor, say the curse has been broken. Say it one more time, say the curse has been broken. Matanda lagabazandadosh. Shout it, say the curse has been broken. It has been broken. It has been broken. It is over now. The curse is no more there. Say it to two persons. Say the course is no more there. Sir, they folded the wrapper. Strangely, you cannot explain, and you are not a child. This is what you discovered while you were lying down sleeping.
Yes, sir.
And the same way they removed it. Now, listen to me. Listen to me. I don't know about you, but I'm a village man. I know what it means for a man to tie wrapper. Eh?
Yes, sir.
When a man is tying wrapper and lying down, for you to completely remove the wrapper, you will pull the man up.
Yes.
Come on now.
Yes, sir.
Because no matter how the wrapper will loose, the man is still lying on top of it.
Yes.
Because he didn't stand up. He didn't get up from there. Then who lifted him and removed the wrapper? And took time to fold it like this. If it were to be in our village, eh?
Yes, sir.
Come on now. Two of us. And this is how God said to me, they have folded you. Matandalaga brother Yagamusha. You are walking around at Abba, but you are folded like this at Acharainobo. You are moving around laboring. You are moving around struggling. You are moving around every day. But this is how you have been folded. And the man folded like this cannot make headway. Pray for you here. Wherever they folded you, however they squeezed your life, today I free you. My sister, you own a school. You own a school. But you don't know what is happening to your school right now. Students are running away. The school seems to be closing down. Somebody said, talk, Nadu, talk. Listen to me. Listen to me. I feel some looking fire in me right now. Permit me to say this to you. Any hand holding you will go down for your sake now. Any man stopping you, heaven will stop that man now. Any power stopping you, God will stop that power now. Somebody receive it as you shout your amen. Somebody receive it as you shout your amen. Somebody receive it as you shout your amen. Where is your husband? He's upstairs. Let him come quickly. I'm going to talk over his workshop right now. I don't know what closed your door, but I will speak right now. Oh God, they shamed you down, but I serve the God of Talk Nadu.
Amen.
I sit in the place of my office. I lose you now.
Amen.
As I lose you, I spread you. You will see good and favor again.
Amen.
In the name of the Father.
Amen.
In the name of the Son.
Amen.
And in the name of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Okay, carry this thing. When you get home, set it on fire.
Thank you, sir.
Carry. Don't set it on fire any other place till you get to your house. Set it on fire outside. Wash it till it will burn. Eat all. It will all burn. After burning, throw out the ashes. When you throw out the ashes, by this time next year, you will have a story to tell me. As I see your tears, you know what I feel? I feel how your school was 4 years ago. You didn't have time to do anything. Pastors, we are coming to do fellowship in your school for you.
Yes, sir.
Because the students who were living there were about 500 and people who were living inside the school. Not to talk of people who come there. The school was blossoming. The woman who was heading your school left your school, opened her own, and packed. She didn't pack the children with empty hand. If she packed them with empty hand, I will leave her. She didn't pack the children ordinarily. If she packed them ordinarily, I will leave her. But when she was leaving, she collected a candle. She burnt the candle in her office. Brought the candle to your office. Burnt a part of it in your office. Gathered the remains of the candle. Poured it in front of the gate. Came back at the middle of the night and packed it again. Went to her own school and poured it in front of her gate. All the students started troubling their parents. Take me there, take me there. Take me there, take me there. Today her school is large, big. Your own is closing down. What are you doing now? You are crying while she is laughing. There are things you don't do empty handed. As the carrier of the prophetic mandate of the God of Talk Nado. You people just went for your midterm break now, Abi. Okay, they are supposed to be resuming by Friday. Oh, yeah, hear me, woman. As they are resuming on Friday, the doors of her school will close. For the doors of your own will open. The doors of her own will close. For the doors of your own will open. The doors of her own will close. For the doors of your own will open. The doors of her own will close. For the doors of your own will open.
I call him Jehovah.
As school is resuming now, I speak by the authority of heaven. The Lord will wipe out your tears. These your tears will turn to tears of joy. I speak as an authority in the kingdom. Her school gate has been closed. The same way she closed your own, I close her own. And I open your own now. The children are coming back with speed. Friday, Monday next week, throughout next week, you will not rest.
Yes, sir.
You will admit and admit and admit. Hey. And admit children and admit children and admit children. You will be so busy. Your school will be so busy. You will employ hands to help you. This is the decree of the watchers. And they shall be established. This case is hereby. Settle. I want to open your workshop. Are you ready to walk? Are you ready to walk? Mantalaya Gabazanda de Bosa. How can somebody slow down the work of your hands when I'm still here? I open it up. Okay, open your hand. Open your hand. I open it up now. Come, they don't want this thing to develop. They don't want it to develop. Eh? Getting 5 months to 6 months, but yet still remaining the same. And it doesn't look like you're seeing any sign again. It will work. Open your hand. Go and do your work. As we close service, anytime we close this service now, before you go home, go straight to your workshop. Touch it and go back home. I speak into your life right now. By the authority in the word of God, those of you who were mandated to die untimely as a result of Father's curse, untimely death is broken out of your head. Yeah. If there be any man or woman in this place on whose neck the curse of untimely death is hanging, whether you know it or not, may the curse be broken today. How many of you know that when you talk about the father's curse, even the wife does not escape from it? There are things your husband will say. He may not know what they mean, but he has entered into covenant on your behalf. I wish I have time to talk on the father's curse. You will hear a lot, but let me give you this very quickly. Every woman here, hear me. When Laban, the father-in-law of Jacob, was looking for his gods, he accused Jacob and told Jacob that Jacob was the one that stole the gods. Out of provocation, for wrong accusation, Jacob said, I will allow you to enter here and search. Anybody in this house that have stolen your God should die. Jacob didn't know that he was placing a death sentence on his wife. He made that pronouncement, and Jacob said, anybody, including me, who has stolen your God, that person should die. And they went in, searched, lo and behold, it was Rachel that stole the gods. But when her husband spoke, as a father of the family, he put a death sentence on her head. She didn't know it. She became the first woman to die in the Bible, giving birth to her son, Benjamin. As she delivered, she became the first woman to die delivering. As she was giving birth to the child, as soon as the child came out of her, she died. Why? As a father, be careful what you say. The father's curse is a powerful curse. If you read the Bible, that is why you should be careful the people you associate with. Anybody carrying the father's curse, if you associate with the person, the curse will come on you. I wish I have time. I will show you in the Bible. Hear from me now. Noah cursed Canaan and said, servant to servant you shall be. You remember? To your brethren. Now hear me. If you go down to read the Bible, many years later, Canaan went and associated himself with the Amalekites and the Hittites, and all of them began to live together. But they didn't know that there was a curse on Canaan, that servant to servant he shall be. After many generations, when the children of Canaan now began to associate with the Amalekites and all of those, as the children of Israel come to that land to inherit the land, listen to what happened. My Bible said, both Canaan and all these nations around him, they became servants to the children of God, because the curse was already hanging on his head. So by association, the Amalekites, the Hittites, and all those who began to associate with him began to suffer the same curse. That is a father's curse. There are people, when you associate with them and they are carrying their father's curse, the curse gets naturally transferred to you. Everybody here, open your mouth and say, I will not die untimely. Open your mouth. Say it one more time. Say, I will not die untimely. Be careful what you say. Be careful what you do. Father's curse is a serious curse. When it comes on a man, number one, it makes you not to live long. Number two, it takes away your lamp. It takes away light from you. Number three, it reduces somebody to a nobody. It reduces you to a nobody. Everybody open your mouth. Say, my father, I will not die untimely. My lamp will not go out. In the name of Jesus Christ. Say, my lamp will not go out. Shout it. Say, my lamp will not go out. My daughter, come. My daughter, come. 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 Come here. Shout it. Say, my lamp will not go out. Do you want to go for this operation? Talk to me.
I don't want to go, sir.
You don't want to go?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that the God I serve can set you free now?
I believe that. I believe.
Somebody say, I will not die your timely. Say it one more time. Say, I will not die your timely. Refuse it. Say, I will not die your timely. Shout it one more time. Say, I will not die your timely. Shout it, shout it. Say, I will not die your timely.
Bible believing mission incorporated, the dwelling place of the God of talking.
There is something hanging on your neck that should not hang anymore. I mentioned a number of scriptures. 21:17. Oh, yeah, give it to me. That causeth his father.
Or his mother.
Or his mother.
Shall surely be put to death.
Anybody that causeth his father or his mother shall surely, mark that word, surely be put to death. Do you know that too many children of this generation are guilty of this? Now, to curse your father doesn't have to be before him. Even though in this generation, children of this generation do it before their father. As I was learning this passage of the scripture, God told me that even those who speak against their father behind them, you are cursing him. Now listen. When you talk about father's curse, it is very deep. Father's curse is very deep. If your father, out of provocation, release a word on your head, it holds. When your mother, out of provocation, release a word on your head, it holds. I'm sorry, but this is the truth. This is the truth. And the Bible says, he that curseth his father shall be put to death. Death. Anytime you put your hand upon a business and the business dies, be careful. Anything you touch must die. I was talking to somebody in Lagos. I said to him, your hand is full of death. Anything you touch dies. He cried. He said, yes, man of God. There are people listening to me right now. Whatever you touch dies. Anything you put your hand on, that thing must die. Anything you touch must die. Anything you touch in the house must spoil. Anything you handle must have problem. Anything you touch must have issue. And he says, whoever curseth his father or his mother shall surely be put to death. Anytime what you see around you is death, 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 death. Any money that enter your hand, the money must die. Connection that enter your hand, that connection must die. Any link you get, that thing must die. Anyone that you associate with, that thing must end. Anything you touch does not survive. It is spirit of death. Today, may the curse be broken out of your life. I said today, may the curse be broken out of your life. Anybody in this house who has been experiencing this death in anything you touch, stand up and stretch your two hands to the altar. Stretch your two hands to the altar. If you have been experiencing it in your life, stretch your two hands to the altar. Say, oh Lord!
Today, I pray, let the spirit of death depart from my life. Let the spirit of death depart from my family. Depart from my life. Stretch your two hands. Say, spirit of death, depart from me. Move out of my life. Move out of my family. In the name of Jesus Christ.
We are going to read this one together. Everybody, pick your Bible. Mark chapter 7. Verse number 10. Somebody lead us in reading so we can read together. Anybody there?
For Moses said, honor thy father and thy mother.
Honor thy father and thy mother.
And whosoever curses his father or mother.
And whosoever curses his father or mother.
Let him die the death.
Let him
die the death.
Let him.
Now hear this. That means there is a debt. There is a debt. That debt is hanging somewhere waiting.
Whosoever curses his father or his mother, let him now die the debt. Every hanging debt in your compound, in your family, over your head, over your life, as we read the word of God today, you will not die the debt. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ.
Very quickly, very quickly. Deuteronomy chapter 5. Deuteronomy chapter 5 and verse number 6. Verse number 6. Now listen, before you read 6, give me 16. Because of my time, let's not read long. Give me 16.
Honor thy father
and thy mother.
And thy mother.
As the Lord thy God has commanded thee.
As the Lord thy God has commanded thee.
That thy days may be prolonged.
That your days may be prolonged.
Huh? And that it may go well with thee.
That it may go well with you. Because when you don't honor your father, when you don't honor your mother, it will not go well with you.
In the land which the Lord thy God has given thee.
In the land which the Lord your God has given you. For it to go well with you, you have to honor your father so that it will go well with you. On this special Father's Day, I pray for you. Any curse upon you that is making things not to go well for you, after today it shall go well for you. 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 Lastly, there are a lot of scriptures to read. Lastly, Ephesians chapter 6, 1 and 2. I pray for you as we are opening the scripture. I pray for you today. Everyone under the sound of my voice. If things were not going well with you as a result of this course before, today I pray for you. It shall go well with you. It shall go well with you. It shall go well with your business. It shall go well with your career. It shall go well in the work of your hands. It shall go well upon your destiny. It shall go well with you.
Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1 and 2.
Children.
Children.
Obey your parents.
Obey your parents.
In the Lord.
In the Lord.
For this is right.
For this is right.
Honor thy father and mother.
Honor your father and mother.
Which is the first commandment.
Which is the first commandment. With a promise. It is a commandment with what?
What is the promise? Can I tell you what the promise is? That your days may be prolonged. That it will go well with you. It's a commandment, but it has a promise attached to it. Why does it have a promise attached to it? Because it is important. You don't have to love your father to obey your father. That is why, let me say this to you. You don't have to love me to obey me. You don't have to like me to obey me. Even if you are 300 years of age and I am 2 days old, honor your parents in the Lord. That's what the Bible says. Listen to me. I owe you honor and you owe me honor. Let's balance it. I owe you honor. You owe me honor. But let me say this to you. I don't get honor from you because I deserve it. I earn honor from you. It is a debt you owe me. You don't say, if you respect yourself, I respect you. No, whether I respect myself or not, you ought to respect me. I earn it. It's like salary. You pay me. I don't have to be right for you to honor me. I don't have to be wrong for you to honor me. You just have to honor me. Come. How many of you understand what I'm saying? That is the first commandment that has a promise attached to it. Deuteronomy 27. I want to close. Deuteronomy 27. Another person, open to Leviticus 20. As you give me Deuteronomy 27 verse 16. Who is there?
I'm here.
Okay.
Verse 16. He says, cursed be he that setteth light by his father.
Cursed be he
that setteth light by his father.
That setteth light by his father.
Or his mother.
Or his mother.
And all the people
shall say
amen.
Is sealed. Cursed be he that setteth light by his father. Can I explain that? Are you looking at your scripture? Somebody give me Leviticus chapter 20. Just hold that one. You will read verse 9. And lastly, somebody will give me the Proverbs 30 and verse 17. And I close. Now, before I do, what does it mean to set light for your father? That's where I want to. I want to explain and I close. Listen to me, children of God. If I just leave it like that, you will not understand what I mean. Cursed be he that setteth light for his father. To set light for your father is cursed be any man that want to examine the father. Anybody that want to investigate the father. Anybody that want to find out whether my father is right or wrong. Anybody that is digging to find out the secrets of his father. Anybody that is digging to expose his father. You are setting light on your father. He said, cursed be he that setteth light on his father. I want to know the kind of man this man is. You are investigating your father. You are setting light. Is the scripture clear to you now? You are setting light on your father. The Bible says, cursed is he. And not just an ordinary curse. He said, let the people say amen. Is sealed. It's a sealed curse. Oh, yeah, give me the Leviticus. 20.
Verse 9. For everyone that curseth his father or his
Everyone that curseth his father or his mother
shall be surely put to death.
Nah. Are you people seeing these things? Are you seeing it in the Bible? Come on, talk to me now. This is Father's Day. Talk to me. Am I the one that wrote it? Why are you looking at me like that? One man of God called me last week. I said, man of God, I had to write down these things. And I was reading them one after the other. I was almost suspecting you. So the whole Bible is full of curses. That's what the man of God. He said, the whole Bible, though. He said, these things are too much. Eh? But they are out there. And you've been carrying this Bible since they born you. He said, cursed be the man that setteth light for his father. In Leviticus 20 verse 9.
For everyone that curseth his father or his mother.
For everyone that curseth his father or his mother.
Shall be surely put to death.
Shall be surely put to death.
He had cursed his father or his mother.
The reason he will be put to death is because he has cursed his father or his mother.
His blood shall be upon him.
Where should his blood be? Now, the original translation says the guilt of his blood shall be upon his head. So that is to say, the death the person will die, nobody will be held responsible. Nobody will be held responsible. The consequences of that person's death will not rest on anybody. It will rest on his head, because he is the one that killed himself. Everybody raise your hand up. Say, Father, in any way that I have offended, spoken against my father, spoken against my mother, oh Lord my God, have mercy on me. In any way that I've spoken against the spiritual fathers, mothers, father, have mercy on me. Redeem me and set me free. Father, let me not die the death. Father, let me not die the death. Any death waiting for me, today I cancel it. Pray. Say, any death waiting for me, today I cancel it. Say, I cancel it. Say, I cancel it. Say, I cancel it. Say, I cancel it. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Bible-believing mission incorporated, the dwelling place of the God of darkness.